Today I want to talk about what scientists mean when they say that something exists. I want to talk about this because every time I give a public lecture, someone will come and tell me that black holes don't exist, or quarks don't exist, or time doesn't exist. Last time someone asked me, do you really believe that gravitational waves exist? So, do I believe that gravitational waves exist? Let me ask you in return, what do you care what I believe? What does it matter for anything? Look, I'm a scientist. Scientists don't deal with beliefs. They deal with data and hypotheses. Science is about knowledge and facts. It's not about beliefs. And what I know is that Einstein's theory of general relativity is a mathematical framework from which we can derive predictions that are in excellent agreement with observation. We have given names to the mathematical structures in this theory. One of them is called gravitational waves. Another one is called black holes. These are the mathematical structures from which we can calculate the observational consequences that have now been measured by the LIGO and Virgo gravitational wave interferometers. When we say that these experiments measured gravitational waves emitted by a black hole merger, we really mean that specific equations led to correct predictions. It is a similar story for the Higgs boson and for quarks. The Higgs boson and quarks are names that we have given to mathematical structures. In this case, the structures are part of what is called the standard model of particle physics. We use this mathematics to make predictions. The predictions agree with measurements. That is what we mean when we say quarks exist. We mean that the predictions obtained with the hypothesis agree with observations. Same story for time. In general relativity, time is a coordinate, much like space. It is part of the mathematical framework. We use it to make predictions. The predictions agree with observations. And that's that. Now, you may complain that this is not what you mean by existence. You may insist that you want to know whether it is real or true. Now, I do not know what it means for something to be real or true. For that, you will have to consult the philosopher. And they will offer you a variety of options that you may or may not find plausible. A lot of scientists, for example, subscribe, knowingly or unknowingly, to a philosophy called realism, which means that they believe a successful theory is not merely a tool to obtain predictions, but that its elements have an additional property that you can call true or real. I'm speaking loosely here because there are several variants of realism, but they have in common that the elements of the theory are more than just tools. And this is all well and fine, but realism is a philosophy, it's a belief system, and science does not tell you whether it is correct. So here's the thing. If you want to claim that the Higgs boson does not exist, you have to demonstrate that the theory which contains the mathematical structure called Higgs boson does not fit the data. Whether or not Higgs bosons ever arrive in a detector is totally irrelevant. Here's a homework assignment. Do you think that I exist? We will talk about this some other time. And don't forget to subscribe.